Hey there, YouTube. I'm going to get a little bit geeky on you here, so if you're into electronics and stuff like that, cool, stick around. You'll learn a couple of things. If not, go ahead and check out my other videos. But today, we're going to learn about quadrature encoders. Some of the motors have built-in encoders in them to sense positions, and I'm going to go through and kind of explain how they work and what the differences are between them and stepper motors. So, stick around. Many CNC machines, such as this one, have what's called a stepper drive. A stepper drive is like this one here. The steppers are very simple in that they're a motor with usually four or six wires coming off. And the way they work is there's two sets of coils. So you fire the first coil, then the second, then the first one, then the second, then the first one, then the second, and it steps a given distance each time. That means the electronics can be very simple. However, it also means that if something stops this motor, there's no feedback to the computer to let it know that it missed a step. On my milling machine, you probably noticed it's a little more involved. There's a motor down here, and then there's another unit up here. Well, inside of here is an encoder, and then down here it's a DC motor. Just a regular DC motor, you apply your voltage and it spins one way or the other. The advantage is, because it has an encoder on it, I know if it's missed a step, and if it does, it can flag an error and stop the machine, which is kind of important when you're dealing with a machine of this size. Some motors, such as this, have an encoder built into them. And if we take the cover off, then you can see inside there's a little electronic circuit and there's a wheel. Now, if you look closely around the edge of the wheel, you may see that there are little tiny microscopic slots. There are several hundred of them around the perimeter. So what this sensor does is it lets us count those slots. And by counting those slots, it lets us know what the position of the motor is. So now what I'm doing is I'm hooking up my digital microscope. In this case, the slots were cut with a laser into a sheet of metal. And you can see that this is a really industrial kind of encoder. The sensor right here is able to read these slots even at high rotational speeds such as this. Now, depending on the electronics that the sensor is connected to, will determine just how fast you can drive this motor. Here's another view. You can see the slots going through the sensor as I rotate this. If I connect two LEDs, light emitting diodes, to my breadboard and I supply them with a ground, I can make them illuminate. I have resistors in there so that I don't overpower them and cause them to overheat. So you can see that I've got two little lights going on. Now, if instead of connecting them directly to ground, I connect them to the quadrature encoder, like this, and I make sure that the quadrature encoder is also connected to ground and power. Then what happens is, as I turn the knob, you can see that the LEDs change states. As I rotate the motor shaft, you can see that I get some output from the encoder. Now there's four possible states. There's both of them off, one on, both of them on, or the other one on. By knowing those states, they're always in the same pattern. So rotating in one direction, I'll get a pattern like this. Rotating in the opposite direction, I'll get a pattern going in the opposite direction. So if I know what one state is, and I count the number of sequences, I know exactly how far this motor has moved. And that's all a quadrature encoder is. Quad for four, because there's four possible states. What I've done now is I've connected up an oscilloscope. An oscilloscope simply allows me to see the waveform of the different signals coming in. So you can see that I've got these two, and as I turn them, you can see the states changing from high to low. And as I go like this, you kind of get an idea that this thing can generate patterns very, very quickly. To give you an idea of the pulses, I've got the motor running very slow right now. And you can see that the LEDs look like they're constantly illuminated. But if we go to the oscilloscope, you can see that they have definite pulses. And as I speed the motor up, you can see the pulses get smaller. And you can see the motors going much faster. So the quadrature encoder has to be able to read the pulses. And depending on how fast the computer can read the pulses, that will determine how fast it can track the motor. I'm running my machine with what's called a Gecko Drive, and they're hard to see, but they're inside of this mess of wires in here. What I've got is I've got DC power coming in, and then I have an encoder signal coming into here, and this determines if it's rotated far enough or not, and if it hasn't, it will send the signals out to rotate this depending on how it needs to be rotated. So to sum it up, here you see the output of one of the channels. When we look at the two channels, you can see that they're a little bit offset from each other. When you look at the different binary numbers, you just see a pattern. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four numbers in the pattern, quad, and you have a quadrature encoder. The little Gecko Drive can read about 25,000 of these pulses every second. And if your computer can handle that, that gives you the maximum speed. Pretty much that's it. That's the quadrature encoders. I hope that helped you. Thank you and have a great day.